Hello everyone, Frank here, and I'm glad that you're here. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to go into a Microsoft Teams meeting, but in a VR immersive environment? Well, that's possible because Microsoft has a product called Microsoft Mesh. And using Microsoft Mesh, we can have virtual meetings. We can join those meetings on our computer. I'll show you how that works. We can join those meetings using a VR headset. In this case, I have the Meta Quest 3. There are some really cool features that we have when we're in these virtual environments, and I'll demonstrate that to you. I'll also talk about some of the things that need to be in place in order for this to work, and I'll do that near the end of the video. First, let's hop in and see what it looks like and how cool it is, and then I'll show you a little bit of how you can set it up for yourself. To demonstrate Mesh, I'm going to set up a meeting. So I'm going to have a meeting between two different people. I'll play both parts. There's going to be Frank, which is me, and there's going to be Bruce Wayne. So I'm currently logged into Teams as Bruce Wayne. I'm going to go into the calendar. I'm going to set up a new meeting. So it's just like creating a regular meeting in Teams. I'm going to go in here. We'll give it some name, something like meshing around. So we'll have some fun here. So we'll go in and call this one meshing around. And the important thing here is I want to make sure that I have all the participants that are going to be there. So I'm just going to go in there and we'll put Frank in there, make sure that I'm in there. And you can see that I now have a meeting. So just a standard meeting and, oh, I've got another one here. I'll close that one. So you can see that I've got this meshing around meeting all ready to go. So as Bruce, I'm going to start this meeting right now. So I'm just going to go into this meeting and join it. I'm going to join the meeting and you'll notice that with Bruce, his camera's currently turned off. So the camera's currently off. Audio settings are the regular audio settings here. So I'm going to join this meeting now and it's going to open a regular Teams meeting. So far, it's just regular Teams. So you could definitely go in. You can see I'm waiting for others to join. But here's where I'm going to make things a little bit different. I'm going to go into the view menu. When I go into the view menu, notice that I can choose an immersive space. So Bruce is going to go into an immersive space, and then Frank is going to join him, but Frank, that's me, by the way. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to run Mesh on the VR headset. So you can see that when Bruce goes in, it'll come up with Microsoft Mesh. The first time you do this, it will go in and ask you to accept license agreements and such. It is important if you want to use Microsoft Mesh that you have a premium subscription to Microsoft Office. So I'm using my business account here, so my corporate account, and I have two licenses, one for Bruce and one for me as Frank. So you can see here, I've got this immersive environment will come up. It takes a few moments to launch, and you'll notice that I'm able to go in here and I can adjust and I can change my avatar, what will appear in that mesh environment. So I have sort of this generic avatar in here. If I go in, I can go in and make changes to this avatar. So for example, I could go in, I could change the clothing. I could have facial hair, body shape. So I could go in and be, you know, maybe a little bit stronger there. I could put, there's a number of prosthetic devices so I can be representative in this environment here as well. I can change my skin tone so that it can match my skin tone a little bit here. So you can put all of these things in here. I can go and change the face shape. I'm not going to go through and show you all of the different options that I have as an avatar. It's a fairly common thing these days to create avatars. So I'll just simply say done to this, and we have my avatar created with all the different options. Notice that I'm choosing to use my S55. So I'm running Microsoft Teams right now on an S55 NearHub whiteboard, interactive whiteboard. I have videos on that as well, but it's a large board and I've got this just over to the side here. The microphone, I can go in and I can choose the microphone that I want to use here as well. So again, you can make changes here as well. So underneath here, if you have a different microphone on here, you can put that on there as well. I'll actually use the microphone that's on the laptop connected to the display. The key here is that you have options. So I'm going to go in here and we'll just go in here. We'll grab that microphone and I'll now join this meeting. So now that I've joined this meeting, the interactive or the immersive space will now show up. And this is the desktop version of Mesh. So now I'll make this full screen just so we get a little bit of a better view here. And I can now navigate this virtual space. So I can use my mouse to navigate around. You can see I've got chairs that I can sit on. So if I sit here, you can see that I'm facing, the meeting will take place here. Anybody who joins this meeting that does not have an immersive space will be able to have their video displayed on the walls here. So it can be a combination of both a virtual space as well as a regular cameras that can appear here on the wall as well. There's some pretty interesting things that we can do here. So for example, let's say I wanted to have a little sidebar conversation. So the main meeting is taking place here and I can choose a seat. So I can go in and choose a seat in the main meeting wherever I may wish to be. But I can also go in and I can move to another area of this immersive environment. So I can go into the seat there. Let's say, for example, I wanted to go over here to the fire pit. So if I go down to the fire pit here, I can just hold my mouse, it'll transport me there, and I can just transport myself here. The key here, you'll notice up here, is that I'm now outside of the meeting zone. So nobody in the meeting zone will hear me, and I can have a conversation with someone here. So there are different zones within this immersive space so that you can move with someone to another area. This is really great if you want to have, for example, a space that has round tables and you can have different participants around different tables, different spaces. If I go back to the meeting, well, this is actually another immersive zone or a separate zone. You can see that the meeting zone has this border around it and this is my immersive space. Again, I can go in and I can do things like reactions. So this will go over my head, some thumbs up, some hearts and such. And I can go into the menu here where I can do things like provide feedback and such. So there are some limitations around what I can do within this space, but you can see that it does give me the ability to participate. Let's put on the headset now and join the same meeting, but I'll come in here as Frank and I will come in and I will show you. Let's just take our Bruce Wayne and we'll have him move into the meeting area. So this is, you can see the meeting's happening up here. So I'm inside the meeting zone. Now let's join with the VR headset and I'll record so you can see what I'm seeing. I'll put on the headset and we'll just pop into the space. I'm just going to set up the recording here. Once the recording happens, then we'll go. Okay, so now I'm going to go in and you'll notice that the space that I have here is actually not really, it's not the same space as I just came from. This is my Meta Quest virtual space, and you can change these around as well. But I'm going to go into Microsoft Mesh, which is an app that I can download from the Meta Store. So I now have Mesh installed, it's part of Teams, and I have Mesh installed on my Oculus as an app. So it'll open up Microsoft Mesh, and I'll log into Microsoft Mesh with my Microsoft account. So I've already logged into Mesh with my account before, so it remembers me. I basically have tied that account to this headset. And you can see here that I've got this meeting here called Meshing Around. Now it is intended to be this evening, it's about 11 minutes, but I can join it now. And when I join it, you can see I have my avatar. I can make changes to that avatar as well. You can see that I've got the virtual space here, so it's already been selected for me. And I'm going to go in and you can see my audio microphone is going to be the Quest headset. I'm going to join, and now I'm going to join the same meeting that Bruce Wayne is in. You can see I look around, it's got the 180 and you can see it kind of stitches together. But now when I go into the immersive space, I can look around. Now I'm going to mute the microphone. So I'm just going to mute the microphone. And we're going to mute some of the audio here just so I don't get as much echo. So you can see here, there's Bruce. Let's go visit Bruce. So I'll sit on this seat. I can zoom around using my joysticks here. Hey, it's Bruce. So I can go here and I can transport myself if I want in front of Bruce. And I can spin around. And now I can wave to Bruce. Now Bruce can't wave to me because he's using the desktop version, but he could emote. So if I go in, I'll just have to sneak on my headset here and have Bruce go ahead and he'll clap. And you can see that those float up. So it's kind of hard to run both at the same time. In the Quest environment, you'll see I can see who's in the meeting. I can chat, so I can type in a message. Hello, Bruce. Of course, I can talk as well. So we'll go in here, hello, Bruce, and send it in. And now I've sent a message to Bruce. Bruce can then chat back. I can go in and I can choose my seat if I wish to sit in the environment. And you can see that if I look around, Bruce will be right there. So there's Bruce. And then I could go in and I could raise my hand, get attention here, lower my hand. I can emote myself. So I can do some emoting there. And then I can have this menu here. I could modify, you know, the settings, the dashboard. So I can bring the dashboard up and see different meetings that are happening. So that's an example of going into that mesh environment, both from the desktop as well as from the VR headset. A key component of making sure that this all works for you, though, is to make sure that you have the Microsoft Teams premium subscription and make sure that it's been enabled by your administrator in the settings for Teams, just to make sure that interactive or immersive environments are permitted. It can be a very interesting way to communicate. There's also different games you can play within that environment. I didn't show it here, but the fire pit, you can roast marshmallows. You can play games like shuffleboard. But if you're interested in seeing that, let me know in the comments below. I can do more videos on Microsoft Mesh and how to integrate it into your Teams meetings. If the video was useful, hit the like button, subscribe for more interesting videos, and we'll see you in the next one. Take care.